In previous videos, we learned how to draw a classic pitchfork and briefly became acquainted with how some modern pitchforks work. In this video, I will explain how to draw modern pitchforks in more detail. And you will notice that they perform better than standard pitchforks in certain conditions. Shift pitchfork is very useful when we are in a trendless market. To draw this pitchfork, we need three pivot points. Points B and C are the same as those used in the standard pitchfork. But to find the base point of the pitchfork, you must do it this way. First, assume that you want to draw a standard pitchfork, with the only difference being that you use the midpoint of A and B as the base of the pitchfork. For this purpose, you can use rectangle and Fibonacci retracement tools from your toolbar. In the following, as you can see, the price has shown suitable reactions to this pitchfork, and after testing the upper parallel line of the pitchfork 3 times, it has penetrated it with a powerful candle and started a bullish trend. Which even after a correction that ended over the top of the pitchfork, continued to move higher with a stronger momentum. Another variation of shift pitchfork is called modified shift, which is slightly different than the first one. This method is also better used when the price is in a correction phase. In this way, we use the intersection of the rectangle's diagonals to find the base point of the pitchfork. In the following, as you can see, the price has shown impressive reactions to the pitchfork lines. Also, some trading platforms automatically draw these types of pitchforks for you. Which shift line should be used depends entirely on the market conditions and the price reaction, and you have to figure it out yourself. In some situations, the modified shift, and in some cases the standard shift, can better capture price fluctuations. Another type of shift pitchfork is called the Deluga pitchfork, which instead of selecting 3 pivots, uses 2 pivots and the midpoint of a wave before it. This pitchfork is also more helpful when the market is consolidating. To find the base point of the pitchfork, as in the previous example, we can use the rectangle tool and find the intersection of its diagonals. In the following, the price has shown appropriate reactions to this pitchfork even after leaving it. And we may use it in the future to estimate the end of the price correction. There is another method to draw a Deluga pitchfork. In this way, we use the midpoint of the second wave before point A to get the base point of the pitchfork. Here, as before, we can use the intersection of the rectangle's diagonals to obtain the base point of the pitchfork. In this example, you can see that the price has twice bounced on the median line and has not crossed it. And after getting out of the pitchfork, it has provided good opportunities for going short. Another type of modern pitchfork is called the T-pitchfork. To draw this pitchfork, we use the midpoint of a virtual swing. If the market's future direction is down, we use two consecutive up fractals. If the market's future direction is up, we use two successive down fractals, which we will discuss in the following example. To find the midpoint of the virtual swing, like the previous examples, we use the intersection of the rectangle's diagonals. In the following, as you can see, the price has shown remarkable reactions to the different lines of the pitchfork, indicating the high credibility of this pitchfork. Then the price starts to fluctuate below the upper parallel line of the pitchfork for a while, which is very important from the price action point of view. And finally, after leaving the T-pitchfork, it has started a powerful uptrend that lasted for 7 months. As mentioned earlier, we can also use the T-pitchfork in an uptrend. In this example, by choosing the two down fractals and finding the midpoint of a virtual swing, we start to draw a T-pitchfork. One of the price's most interesting behaviors towards the pitchfork's different lines is that it wraps around them like ivy. Here you see that the price is rising by twisting around the median line. But usually, after a while, this price behavior stops, and suddenly a strong trend begins. In the following, the price leaves the pitchfork and then does the same with the lower parallel line of the pitchfork. And finally starts a downtrend. So with the help of this pitchfork, we could identify the trend change and manage our trades based on that. If you enjoy this type of content and want to know more about Andrew's pitchfork, please leave us a like to show your support. Also subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon to stay in touch when we upload new videos. Have a good time.